the roads are going to be bad today because it snowed and it iced and it spit all night. But let me tell you, the roads are clear. Family is here. And the only attitude of expectation we have this morning is we expect God to do something amazing in this place today. The expectation we have this morning is that miracles still happen and God's got it for you because you are favored, loved, and anointed. This is the place to be today. Welcome to it. We are going to worship together this morning. Pray with me. Father God, we are here. Let our praises be your throne. We are here to honor, to worship, and to glorify your name. Let's do that, church family, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Fighter, healer, redeemer, the greatest one, you have overcome. Oh, 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 Savior, ruler, king, you're the risen one, our victory has come, you are the greatest one.
storms shall prevail. Your word is stronger, we overcome. Yeah. Glory resounds through the age, all saints declaring.
On the outside, we got so much heat on the inside called the Holy Spirit. Come on, somebody. You know, my name is Steve Flores, and I'm one of the executive pastors here at First Assembly Church, and it is my sincere honor to welcome you home to First Assembly Church. And for those of you who don't know, our church is on a mission, and our mission is to declare and display the gospel to everyone, every day, and everywhere. And how do we do that? We reach up and we worship God. We reach in
and we serve one another, and we reach out and we change the world. And we want you to be a part of a movement here at First Assembly Church. And God is doing amazing things in and through us. And we want you to be a part of this amazing church service. Now, as we transition, I want to invite all of those. How many of you guys have ever received Jesus Christ as your personal life and Savior? Come on, y'all. Okay, I'm talking to you. If you want to get baptized right now, this is Baptism Sunday. If you can see my wife right over here, Tara Flores. And if you want to get baptized right now, go ahead and make yourself available to her. We have t-shirts, we have shorts, we have all the good stuff for you, because we want to make sure that you have an opportunity for you to declare, publicly declare your lordship to Jesus Christ. Amen. So real quick, if you're interested, go ahead and meet Pastor Tara and we'll make things happen. God bless you guys.
Taking us higher, and we go from glory to glory to glory. storm surrounding me, let it break at your name. Still call the sea to still, the rage in me to still, every wave at your name. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, you silence fear. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, recall these bones to live, call these lungs to sing once again. And I will praise Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, you silence fear. Yes, Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, oh Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, you silence fear. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, your name is a light that the shadows can't deny. Your name ever heard. Just say his name, just say Jesus, and every demon will tremble. Say Jesus, 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 Jesus. Your name is a light that the shadows can't deny. Your name cannot be overcome. Your name is alive, forever lifted high. Your name cannot be overcome. Your name is alive, that the shadows can't deny. Your name cannot be overcome. Speak it out. Declare his name today. Jesus, Jesus. Say it with authority, amen. Come on, and say his name. Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. we're moving in. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus.
Let's continue to give him praise, church. He's worthy of it. Lift up his name now. Give him a shout of praise this morning. Shake these walls with praise. He's worthy of a hallelujah. We praise your name, Jesus. My goodness, there's something about that name. Jesus. Well, hey, my name's Patrick. I'm one of the pastors here on staff at First Assembly Church. Like I said earlier, if it's your first time here today, welcome home. We are excited to have you here. Thank you for worshiping with us. Let's continue in the spirit of joy. I want to give you guys a chance to just walk around, squeeze a few necks, shake a few hands, just say good morning to each other this morning. As you guys find your seats, we got a few things to tell you about this morning that we're excited about. First off, again, if it's your first time, welcome home. We are so excited that you've come and joined us and our family this morning here at First Assembly Church. But we would like to get to know you just a little bit better. So as you're seated, if you would look in the seat back in front of you, there is a card, a connection card in that seat back in front of you. If you would fill that out, and when the opportunity comes around, there'll be some containers, just drop it in that containers, or see us at the Welcome Center up front. We would love to get to know you. Additionally, how many of you guys get excited when Jesus changes a life? Oh, come on, that's not good. How many of you guys get excited when Jesus changes a life? All of heaven parties. Hey, we experienced it this morning with water baptism, and we rejoice in those lives just as all of heaven is rejoicing as people declare their faith. I want to let you know January 26th is our next water baptism. You can sign up for it. I believe it's at the Welcome Center as well, Pastor Steve. Welcome Center, you can sign up for water baptism. We'll have the stuff for you that day if you decide that day. I'm making that declaration. We'll be ready for you.
That's going to be awesome. Real quick, guys. Coffee and Connect. Have you guys ever heard of that? I'm going to tell you real quick. If you are a first-time guest here at First Assembly Church for the last 2.5 months, we want to invite you to Coffee and Connect. That's Sunday, January the 26th at 9 a.m. in the multipurpose room. I will be personally giving all of the first-time guests a call because I want to make sure you connect with all the pastoral team to make sure you know what our vision's about, what our mission's about, because we're going to connect with all of you guys to make sure that you guys are a part of a wonderful church. So again, Coffee and Connect. For all the first-time guests, join us Sunday, January 26th at 9 a.m. in the multipurpose room. Pastor Katie.
Hello, everybody. Good morning. Who knows that we are passionate about prayer at First Assembly Church? We are passionate about prayer. I'm a product of prayer. I can look over this congregation and see saints that prayed for me when I couldn't pray for myself. So there is still a lot more of me out there, guys. So we are going to be having a prayer service from January 27th to January 3rd, the 26th through the 30th. And that's going to start on a Sunday. But you want to make sure you don't miss that Wednesday night. It's going to be a great night. You say, well, I've never done that before. I don't know if praying's for me. Maybe it's for the person sitting next to me. No, praying is for you. Step out this year. Break out and do something you've never done before and see God move in a way that he's never moved before. Have a great day, guys.
Come on, somebody, give God praise. Come on, give God praise today. Pastor Steve, if you could help me get my podium out here for a second. You look good today. Thank you for being here on Sunday, a snowy St. Louis Sunday here. And we want to say welcome to all of you. And we want to welcome all of you that are watching online today. God bless you watching all the way from California. Can we just, California, the Southwest and the Northeast and Florida. If you're from California or Florida watching right now, can you send us some sunshine? Come on, can you just do that for us today? We'd love for you to send some sunshine our way. Can we welcome all of our online guests today that are tuning in today? God bless you guys. We're glad that you're here. Tuning in, watching with all the saints here in St. Louis. We are in St. Louis. Y'all are saints, right? Come on, somebody. Y'all are saints in the house. We get the privilege of being generous today, and I'm going to encourage you to prepare your generosity with me. As you're preparing your generosity, today is a mission Sunday, and we're going to introduce to you some missionaries that you're familiar with, but today we want to highlight a special missionary that's with us today. But before they come out and share, you'll see a few different ways that you can be generous on the screen behind me. You can give today using an envelope that are provided for you in the seat pockets right in front of you. Grab one and tuck a little something in there. We're going to be praying this month over all the offerings that come in because we believe this first month, what we give in the first month of this a brand new year and a brand new decade, we're going to ask God's blessings to be over the rest of your year. We believe prophetically that what is blessed first lasts throughout the rest of the year. And so we're going to ask that God will bless your tithe and your offering today. I'm going to talk about that in just a second. You can also give today online. And if you're watching at home online, thank you. Stay faithful in your generosity today. We posted out this morning on our Facebook and Instagram how you can do that safe and secure through our website. You can follow along there or you can text to give today. I'm doing both. I already text to give and I've got my envelope ready. I'm ready for a double blessing in 2020. Anybody want a 2020 blessing this year? Come on, I want a 2020 blessing. Come on, somebody. So today, as you prepare your gifts, here's what the word of the Lord says. Malachi 3:10, bring in the tithe into the storehouse that there may be food in my house. And thereby put me to the test, says the Lord, if I will not throw open the windows of heaven for you and pour down on you an overflowing blessing. Now, I love that. There's a lot of reasons why I love it, but quickly, let me just share with you why. Number one, I love the fact that God says that we could test him. Test him. This is one of the only places in Scripture where God says, test me in this. You know, if you got anything over the holidays, most everything that you bought comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? A 30-day money-back guarantee. And I love that God says, test me in this. Test me. Try me. Have a 30-day money-back guarantee if I won't do what I say I will do. I love that. You know, God says to try him. The word prove in Scripture is the Hebrew word that means to test or to try in the area of tithing. Watch. He promises that those who try tithing, giving 10% of your income to the Lord, not to the church, but to the Lord. You're giving to the Lord. That those that give 10% of their income to the Lord, he promises that those who try him in this area, that he would throw open the windows of heaven and pour on them blessings that are too numerous for you to even contain. I love that. Watch. In 2020, watch. Tithing leads to thriving. Come on, somebody. Tithing leads to thriving. And I'm going to be encouraging this church throughout the year. Try God. Test God. See if he won't be true to his word. I don't know about you, but in my 42 years on this planet, God has never failed me yet. God has never let me down. I've never gone without. I know it's been tight, but it got right because God always came through at the right time. And my wife and I, we've committed to tithing our entire marriage, and we've seen God come through time and time and time again. Tithing leads to thriving. And in 2020, I want you not just to survive, but I want you to thrive in 2020. Punch your neighbor on the shoulder real quick and say, I want you to thrive in 2020. All right, that's looking good. Some of you got to work on your punch in 2020. Come on, some of you got to work on your punch in 2020. Now, I want you guys to celebrate with me some incredible missionaries coming out today that we love and we support. Would you please welcome today, put your happy hands together for Pastors Jim and Rochelle Boone as they come out today. Missionaries. Northern Missouri missionaries, homegrown heroes in the house. Pastor, God bless you. God bless you. Please share quickly with the people. Mission Sunday, what God is doing through the ministry that you are a part of. Go ahead.
Well, in case you don't know, Birch House is a transitional home in St. Peter's. It's set up to help women transition from the lifestyle of addiction and into recovery. This church supports them. Birch House is a U.S. missions project under Reach Missouri Network and Pastor Jerry Harris. We began itinerating, raising our support in March of 2019, our 2019. Our first support came from people in this church as well as this church itself.
Come on. Yes.
We are truly excited to be able to continue the success of Birch House and to help grow and expand Birch House ministry. The Birch House would never be the tremendous success it is without the people in this church and this church itself. Mentors, pastors, financial support, fundraisers, volunteers. It's impossible to name everyone, but to everyone who has invested time and their treasures and talents in those women, we thank you. God set Rochelle and I up for this. I got out of the Bridgeway van in 2005, and God began preparing me for this ministry. But because of constant relapse, because I had not surrendered and given my life to Christ, I tried to sabotage God's plan, but God wouldn't allow it for me or for Rochelle. We're both Teen Challenge graduates. I am now licensed as a minister in the assemblies. Rochelle is working on hers as well. And this, I'm telling you right now, this is in no way a reflection of us, because many of you saw me from 2005 to 2011 in my mess. It was nothing I could have done. It's 100% a reflection of God, His grace, and His love. God does not call the qualified. He takes broken vessels like you and I and uses us to show His power and His grace. We are blessed to be able to provide a bridge of hope from addiction into recovery and to pour into the lives of those coming out of addiction and continue to grow this ministry. We love you guys. We thank you for believing in the Bridge House, and we thank you for believing in us. We will be in the lobby after the service to provide more information about the ministry, what you can do if you're interested in partnering with us, walk alongside of us, whatever it is that you need to know. We'll be out there afterwards. Blessings.
Come on, somebody. Thank you so very, very much. God bless you guys. Thank you. Amen. Amen. Most of you would come and position yourselves to serve the people, and I'm going to ask our elders to prepare themselves to come forward to be able to pray over these, your gifts here this first of the month. Amy, if you would come and position yourself as well to be able to pray over these. When you give, you're giving to missionaries above your tithe, above the 10% offerings that go to support over 50 missionaries, not just here in the United States like Jim and Rochelle Boone, but around the world. And so we want you to know that your effort, your energy, your time, your talent, your treasure is going to make a difference in the lives of incredible people. You saw a product of that on the stage just a moment ago. You see a picture of that in baptism and these wonderful people that we get to minister to on a weekly basis. And church, we want to continue. And I believe at some point in time in the future, we're going to see a men's house at some point in time here in the future. I believe that's going to come. So if you would, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to ask you to put your generosity in your hands. We're going to pray over it right now. Just a general prayer first. The hosts are going to come. They're going to collect it. They're going to bring it to the front. As our custom, the first of the month, this first month of the year, we're going to pray a special blessing over it here in just a moment. And we're going to ask the Lord to bless it. So Father, we thank you right now for the privilege of giving. We ask as your people give, whether it's electronically, online, or in an envelope, or cash in the opportunity container. We ask, Lord, your hand of favor to be upon it, and we pray that you would be true to your word, those that are testing you in this season. Lord, we thank you for the reports that have already come in this year of, Lord, increase, jobs, miracles that have already happened. We thank you, Lord, that you are faithful to your word in Jesus' name. And all God's saints said together, Amen. God bless you as you give. We're going to come back and we're going to declare some things over this in just a moment. Elders, if you would come. The hosts are bringing the opportunity containers to the front. I believe that we're going to be prophetically declaring some things over you, your house, your family, your marriage, your children. We're going to be declaring some things that the Lord's given me to be able to speak over you. The eldership of this church representing you, the people of First Assembly Church. They're charged with the spiritual oversight of the house. These are men of God, their wives. We want for you, if you ever have a need for anything, come find one of these men and ask for prayer. And we're going to believe that the prayer of faith will avail much. So what I'm going to ask you to do is this. Stretch your hands towards these containers here, right here. And as we lay our hands on them, and as I pray, I want you to pray as well, because this represents your increase in 2020. So saints, lift your voices. We're going to declare this in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, we come to you now in the name of Jesus. And we join our value system with your value system. God, as we lay our hands upon these containers today, these represent the first fruits, the offerings, the gifts, the time, the talent, and the treasure of your people. And today, as we declare these, as our custom is, we receive today's offering, and we're believing you for an open heaven today in the name of Jesus. We're believing you for earth to be invaded. We pray for the storehouses of heaven to be unlocked. We pray for miracles to be created. We declare dreams and visions, declarations, impartations, divine manifestations to come to the people of God. We pray for the anointing, the gifting, the call of God to be released in this house through the people of God. We pray for positions of increase for your people this year in 2020. We pray for promotion for your people in 2020. We ask, Lord, right now for provision for your people in 2020. May all of their needs be met according to your riches and glory that are found in Christ Jesus. We pray for resources to find your people. We pray that money would come that's assigned to them in 2020. May it come from unusual places and spaces. May it come at the right time when it's exactly needed. God, I pray that the gifts that are given today would go to the nations. On this Mission Sunday, we declare increase for every missionary and every missions work that we support and more in the name of Jesus. We pray for an expanded kingdom outreach. For the kingdom is our declaration. Lord, this good news is too good to keep in one location. So God, we pray for kingdom expanse, kingdom increase, kingdom influence to the nations, God. We pray for souls and more souls in this community and around the world. Your word says that we could ask for the heathen as our inheritance. So we ask for that in the name of Jesus. Bring the lost home. Let those that are in darkness see a great light. Lord, I pray that those that haven't heard would hear. Because there's a church that's a sending church. There's a church that's a giving church for the kingdom. God, we thank you, Lord, for every generation. We pray from our children to our teenagers to the young adults of our community. We pray a reach from this church into the next generation through these gifts. God, we pray for those to be saved and set free from every addiction, every demonic force that would try to penetrate them. Lord, we pray right now that they would be safe and secure in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father. Lord, as again, we join our value system with yours. Lord, I ask and I declare and decree over your people that you would show them favor and blessing and increase so that they might have more than enough in 2020. I declare plenty in 2020 for your church and your people in Jesus' name. And all God's saints said together, Amen. God bless you. Give God a good clap of praise today. I think you can do better than that. Give him a good praise today. Amen and amen. 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 We are excited about today. Go ahead, and if we can, let's do this. Grab your Bibles, get them out, and get ready. Take a look at the big screen real quickly here today, because we're going to jump in and we're going to finish part one of this opening message in the series, the Decade Series. So take a look at the big screen while you grab your Bible this morning. Church, it's a pleasure to be with you today again on this snowy Sunday here in St. Louis. And one more time, can we put those happy hands together and give Jesus praise today? Come on, somebody. Give him a good praise today. It's good to see your smiling faces. And real quick, just as a warm-up, because y'all look good today, just turn to your neighbor real quick and tell him you look good. Go ahead. Now turn to that other neighbor and say, you look better than you did last year. Just go ahead and tell them that. You look better than you did last year. Yeah, thank you, my friend. You look better than you did last year. My goodness. I tell you what, I'm excited to get into the second part of this teaching series today, the Decade Series. And if you have your Bible or your smartphone, you can open it up and get prepared there. If you want to, on your smartphone today, follow along on the YouVersion Bible app. I'd encourage you to go ahead and grab that. There's a live event. You can take notes on there. All the scriptures are going to be on there. But we want for you to follow along as we go, because we want you to pray and meditate on these things as you go throughout your week. And I want to invite you personally to our Wednesday night midweek worship experience, where we're going verse by verse through Psalm 91, God's Prayer of Protection. Our Wednesday night midweek services are growing and increasing, and we want you to be there. There's an anointing on midweek, and we know that that as our world gets darker and darker, come on somebody, the light shines brighter and brighter. And we're called to shine bright in a dark time. And God gives us a prayer of protection found in Psalm 91. And as we go verse by verse through it, there's some incredible truths that we want for you to gain out of it. So join us Wednesday night, midweek, 7 p.m. right here. Thanks for the whole family, small groups for kids and teenagers. And we'd love for you to be able to join us on our Wednesday nights. All right. Let's ask the Lord's blessing on his word, and we're going to dive right in and get to the finish line on this second part of our opening message for the Decade Series. Almighty God, we come to you in the name of Jesus, and we start by first acknowledging you. Your word says if we would acknowledge you in all we do, you would guide and direct our paths. So before we take any further steps today, we acknowledge you. I thank you for your people that have honored you with their presence in this house. They have not forsaken the gathering of the saints together. We thank you for the corporate anointing that is here in this house. We pray for that same anointing to be present with those that are watching, that are a part of our family online right now. Lord, your word declares that we are to give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God for us in Christ Jesus. And so we do that right now. We give you thanks for everything that we have encountered and experienced up to this point. Lord, we know that there are some days when it's good and important to remember where we've come from. We look back for a moment, but Lord, we look ahead to what you're doing. We declare here at First Assembly Church that you are doing a new thing, and we want to perceive it. We want to see it. We want to sense it. We want to have your spirit witness to us on the inside what you are doing here in this place. Lord, I pray that today for those that have gathered together under the sound of my voice, Holy Spirit, I pray give them ears to hear what the Spirit is speaking to them. Holy Spirit, put me on, wear me like a coat. Only allow me to say what you want me to say. We make a confession here today that we are here on purpose because we have a purpose. Our hearts are open and our minds are ready to receive because we declare you're not finished with us yet. Our best days are still ahead of us, and we declare that victory is ours because the victorious one lives on the inside of us today. Jesus, thank you for your presence. Bless your word. And we'll give you all the glory and the honor for it in Jesus' name. And all God's saints said together, amen, amen, and amen. There's an anointing of the Lord here today, and we're so excited about what the Lord is about to do. We talked about this. This is part two of a message that we started last week entitled, I Am Blessed. And we talked about last week that behavior follows identity. And in this new decade, this new year that we are embarking on, that we want for you at First Assembly Church not simply to just encounter God's blessings just for today, but we want for you to walk in the perpetual blessings of God. We want you to begin to believe that you are blessed and highly favored. I love the story of Brother Ole, who was an elder here for a long time. And he used to say that he was blessed and highly favored. Whenever you ask Brother Ole how he was, he would always say, I'm blessed and highly favored. That man believed that he was blessed and highly favored. And I believe that when old patterns are broken, watch, new worlds emerge. And we talked about last week that when we begin to trust the Lord and begin to believe in our identity in Christ, who we are in Christ, that God begins to unlock not just his blessings for today, but come on somebody, blessings for tomorrow and the next day and the next week and the next month and the next year and the next year and the next year. And I believe that God is calling this church to one of its greatest seasons of ministry that we've ever encountered before. In our prayer times, I believe as a corporate church, and I'm calling on you to come and join us for that week of prayer that we're going to be having here at this church. I'm calling for you to come and make it a priority. Bring your family, bring your children. Parents, teach your children how to pray. Parents, lead the way in your home. We're going to have a powerful time of prayer. But I believe as we've prayed as a staff, as eldership, as deacons, that there's a sense that we are breaking out in 2020. And we want you to experience the great blessings of God. We talked about what is a blessing. If you could define it, what is a blessing? We talked about this last week. If you missed it, we're going to highlight this real quickly. But what is a blessing? A blessing means to speak a good word. To speak a good word. A blessing means a good word. It's actually more powerful than that because a blessing isn't a thing. It is the divine favor of God that is spoken over you. Numbers chapter 23, verse 19 and 20. If you missed it last week, you can see it on the screen behind me. Make sure this is a verse you need to have in your Bible, on your, highlighted in your Bible, on your smartphone. You need to put it anywhere you look during the week. If you're in the bathroom more often in the week, put it in the bathroom. If you're, you know, keep it away from the refrigerator, put it in the refrigerator when you open the door. Put it someplace, right? This is what a blessing looks like. This is what God's promise to us is. Look at this. God is not a man that he should lie. Thank you, Jesus. Or the Son of Man that he should change his mind. Has he said it and will he not do it? Or has he spoken it and will he not fulfill it? He has blessed and it cannot be reversed. God's blessings for you have been spoken over your life. And when God speaks a blessing, he does not revoke it. He will do it. He will do it. We talked about Ephesians 1 verse 3. Where it talks about Paul, in the New Testament, your new covenant perspective on that verse, Ephesians 1, 3, he says this, all praise to God, the Father of our Lord and Jesus Christ. Look at this. Who has blessed you, who has blessed us as a church with every spiritual blessing in heavenly realms because we are united with Christ. Church, your blessings. How many blessings do you have? You have all of them. When do you receive those blessings? Now, not someday, not in the good old sweet by and by, but here in the nasty now and now. God has given you his blessings today, and they are all found in Christ Jesus. They're all found in Christ. God's supernatural blessings, they affect everything about your life. John 1:16 declares this, that out of his fullness, out of the fullness of his grace, he has blessed us all, giving us one blessing after another. I'm just reading your Bible to you today. This is in your Bible. You are blessed, child of God. You are blessed. You are blessed. Touch your neighbor real quick and say, you are blessed. You're not talking to the right neighbor. They don't believe it. Turn to the other neighbor. Say, you are blessed. I want you to begin to believe that you are blessed. You are blessed. The common word in the New Testament, the Greek word for blessing, was the Greek word makairos, which was a reference to this ancient island of Cyprus that was all self-containing. It had everything it needed. It was lacking nothing. It didn't need to import anything. It didn't need anything externally. It had everything it needed to survive and to sustain. And Jesus uses this word, John 1:16, he uses the same word to describe what he does for you. Out of the fullness of whose grace? Jesus' grace. Jesus has blessed us all, giving us one blessing after another. Church, I want you to understand as we kick off this new year that not only are you blessed, but you lack nothing in your life. I want you to begin to believe that in your life, you lack nothing. I want you to begin to believe that in your marriage, you lack nothing. I want you to begin to believe in your finances, you lack nothing. I want you to believe in your body, that you lack nothing. Why? Because Jesus has promised out of his grace to give you one blessing after another. Now, old school saints, we used to sing a hymn back in the day. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Come on, somebody. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings. Count your many blessings and see what God has done. What if instead of looking at your problems, what if instead you started counting your blessings? What if instead of complaining about the government, you'd start counting your blessings? What if instead of complaining about your community, you would start counting your blessings? What if instead of complaining about your spouse, don't look at them right now, you'd start counting your blessings? What if instead of just complaining about your kids that drive you crazy, you'd start counting your blessings? What would that do to you? What would that do to your mood? What would that do to your perspective? What would that do to your view of your life? Everything you have in life is a blessing from God. The tragedy is many of us think that what we've got, we've earned it. I talk to people all the time saying, Pastor, you don't know, but I work for what I got. I'm a self-made man. I'm a self-made woman. I pulled myself up from my own bootstraps. I hear people say that to me all the time. I said, where'd you get your boots? Where'd you get your straps? Where'd you get your ability to work? Where'd you get your creativity? Where'd you get your intelligence? Where'd you get the next breath in your body? Where did you, listen, everything you have is a gift of God's grace. Everything we have. So we give praise to God to the glory of his son, Jesus Christ, who has given us everything we need for life and godliness. Church, you lack nothing. In 2020, I want you to raise your faith level. I want you to begin to declare and decree that you lack nothing in Jesus Christ. He is your source. Watch. He is your source and he is your supply for everything you need in Christ Jesus. I know you might look at your body and say, but Pastor, I got a doctor's report. Yes, I understand that there's a doctor's report, but I here to declare to you today that by his stripes you have been made whole in Christ Jesus today. I understand that your bank account may look like there's more month than there is money, but I'm here to declare to you that he has promised in Christ to supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory that are found in Christ Jesus. It's all found in Christ. The PIN code, watch. If you have a debit card, you understand what this means. If you have a debit card, you have also been assigned a PIN code. That PIN code unlocks your bank account, right? If you lose your PIN code, what happens? You get locked out. If somebody steals your PIN code, they get access to what you got. Right? In your New Testament, read your New Testament. Go to the book of Colossians. I'd encourage you to start there and circle every time you read in Christ. Because the PIN code to unlocking the blessings of God for you in the New Covenant, your Bible, in your life, are found in two words. In Christ. In Christ. If you are found in Christ, guess what? Heaven unlocks to you. Everything that Jesus has, guess what? You've got. It's all found in Christ. In Christ, you lack nothing. You are blessed. You are blessed. Now, let me give you a quick summary, quickly today. Quick summary of what the Bible says about his blessings in your life. This is your Bible. Do your biblical due diligence. Google it for me, okay? Listen, if you don't believe me, go to your Bible, go Google it this week. But here's a quick summary of what the Bible says about the blessings, his blessings in your life. Number one, we don't deserve it, but he gave it to us anyway. Come on, somebody. I don't deserve it, but he gave it to me anyway. Out of the fullness of his grace, he has blessed us, giving us one blessing after another. We talked about this. Listen, I don't want you believing that God is the God of an eyedropper blessing, that he just drops a little blessing on you every once in a while. If I'm a good little boy or girl, then I get a little blessing. No, I don't want you to believe that. Maybe you believe that God's the God of a little shot glass. I just need a little shot of blessing today, God. I need a little shot of blessing today. No, some of you believe that he just gives you enough for today, but you got to hope for tomorrow. God wants you to begin to believe that he's the God of the super big gulp. Come on, somebody. He's the 7-Eleven super big gulp. And not only that, but he gives you free refills. Right? Come on, somebody. God's the God of free refills. Some of you, you just need to say, I'm cutting back on my blessings a little bit. Just one cup a day, God. Well, listen, fill my cup, Lord. Fill it up, Lord. Right? Fill my cup, Lord. I want all the blessings that you've got for me. I want them all, not just one cup of it, Lord, but I want you to come back, God, and give me so much more. Cup full to overflowing, because I'm blessed to be a blessing to others. I want God's blessing on your life to spill out onto somebody else. I know we don't deserve it. I don't deserve God's blessings, but he gives it to me anyway. Number two, God blesses you because he enjoys doing it. I love this right here. Jeremiah 32:41. I will enjoy blessing them. This is God speaking with all my heart and soul, and I will be faithful to plant them in this land. Listen, I want you to know that God blesses you because he enjoys doing it. He enjoys blessing his kids. Number three, God has already stored up blessings for you. Psalms 31:19. Lord, you have stored up great blessings for those who honor you. Listen, he's already stored them up for you. He's got blessings on reserve. You got blessings on layaway. Come on, somebody. God's got blessings on layaway for you. He says, listen, I've got them stored up for you. Great blessings for those that honor me. I love this one. Number four, God wants to bless you visibly and publicly in front of people. I don't know about you, but I want that in 2020. I love this right here. Psalms 31:19, the B part of that verse. Look at this. Lord, you've stored up great blessings for those who honor you. You do much for those who come to you for protection, blessing them before the watching world. I love that. I want God in 2020 to bless you so much publicly that when people look at you, they say, how are you so blessed? And you've got a testimony at that point in time. Say, I'm blessed, not because I deserve it, but because God wants to bless his kids, and I'm a king's kid. And because I'm a king's kid, I walk in blessing, and I want you to know that it was God that gave me my blessings. God gave me my blessings. Number five, God blesses you so that you can be a blessing to other people. I love this one right here. Ezekiel 34:26. I will cause my people, I love this right here, and their homes around my holy hill to be a blessing. And I will send showers of blessings which will come just when they are needed. I don't know about you, but I want your house to be blessed. I want your property to be blessed. I want your roof to be blessed in 2020. I want your furnace blessed in 2020. I want your yards to be the greenest yards in the neighborhood. Come on, somebody. I want your dogs blessed. I want everything about, what. Listen, when you position your home around the Lord and the Lord's purposes, he promises to bless you. He says, I'll send showers of blessings, watch, which will come just when they are needed. I know things might be tight, but God is always faithful to come through. God is always faithful to come through. Number six, I love this one right here. God's blessings are multi-generational. This is important. God's blessings are multi-generational. You can actually pass on blessings, the blessings of God to the next generation. I hear some people say, well, Pastor, that's all good, but it's a little too late for me. I'm on the backside of the mountain. I'm not a spring chicken anymore. I've already passed middle age. I got some miles on my tires. Here's the good news. It's never too late to get in on what God's up to. It's never too late to get in on what God's up to. How do I know that? Job 42, verse 12. The Lord blessed Job in the second half of his life even more than the first half. I'm talking to some saints in the house today. Listen, God bless. I believe in 2020, God's going to bless your retirement better than he blessed your working days. I'm gonna believe you're more blessed in your retirement. And I love this right here at First Assembly Church. We want you to awaken to God's blessings that are in your life right now and begin to pray those blessings on the next generation. Pray those blessings. Listen, when you see kids running through the hallways, I want you, if you're a saint in the house today, I want you to lay your hands on those kids and I want you to declare a blessing over them. Speak a good word over them. Speak the word of God over them. Why? Because what are we doing? We're passing on from one generation to the next generation. That one generation, David said, testified to the next generation of the goodness of God. Listen, I believe that God has blessings stored up for you. Now, how do we live in the blessings of God? Here's where we're going to go today. How do we live in the blessings of God that are yours in Christ? Number one, you can write it down anywhere on your notes, on your phone. Here we go. Number one, we receive God's blessings through Jesus Christ. Through Jesus Christ. I want to teach you today how we receive and how we operate in the blessings of God. We receive God's blessings through Christ Jesus. Go back to Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3. Here's what it says. Through Christ, God has blessed us with every spiritual blessing that heaven has to offer. Through Christ. Every blessing, watch, every blessing that heaven has stored up for you, that God does for you, through you, with you, in you, because of you, is only because of Christ in you. It all starts with Jesus Christ. Not because you're good or bad, not because you do good or do bad, but simply because of Jesus Christ. Watch, if you want to live in God's blessing for your life in 2020 and in this decade, and I want that for you, listen, it doesn't start, watch, with a premise, and it doesn't start with a principle. It starts first with a person. His name is Jesus. That's why we want you to meet Jesus. We don't want you to meet religion. We don't want you to meet rituals. We don't want you to meet routines, although there's nothing wrong with good spiritual disciplines, and we're going to talk about that in 2020. We're going to talk about all these other things that are important, but if you miss the person of Jesus, you've missed the whole thing. We want for you to meet Jesus. Jesus makes the difference. Jesus is the one that is the giver of every blessing. In Christ, we participate in every blessing that God has promised to us. I love this scripture right here, Galatians chapter 3, verse 14 and 29. I'm going to come back and teach on this later on in 2020, but I love this verse of scripture. Look what it says here. In Galatians 3, 14 and 29, it says that the blessings of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles. Well, who's a Gentile? A Gentile is anybody that's not a Jew. That's you and me. That the blessings that were found on Abraham's life might come upon the Gentiles, watch, in Christ Jesus. That we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. And if you are Christ's, then you're Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. There are some powerful things that God promised to Abraham in the old covenant. But in the old covenant, there was also something that was missing. It was missing Jesus. It was a type. It was a shadow. It lacked the substance. But Jesus was the perfect one that came, was the substitution for you and for me. But what God promised Abraham was powerful. He promised him greatness. He promised him fruitfulness. He promised him health. He promised him great rewards. He promised Abraham world-reaching blessings. He promised Abraham a long life. He promised Abraham abundant prosperity. He promised Abraham protection and so much more. But there was a list in the old covenant of you do this and God does that. If you don't do this, then there's a curse. But at the cross, Jesus took away the curse. The Bible says that cursed is any man that hangs on the tree. So watch, Paul says this. That if you are in Christ, you're a part of the new covenant. You are a part of this new agreement that God makes, not of you do this and I do this. Jesus took the curse, watch, so you get all the blessings and none of the curses of the Old Testament, and you get all the blessings of heaven in the new covenant found in Christ Jesus. I don't know about you, but that sounds like a great deal to me. Because not only do I get all the blessings that Abraham had, but I get all the blessings of the new covenant. What are some of the blessings in the new covenant? These are in your Bible. Number one, you're saved by grace. Number two, you're forgiven by grace. Number three, you're strengthened by grace. Number four, you're set free by grace. Number five, you're given talents by grace. Six, you're used by grace. Seven, you're kept by grace. Eight, you're transformed by grace. Nine, we grow by grace, and so much more. Child of God, this is all things that God promises you if you're found in Christ Jesus. That in 2020, this year of blessing for you, I want you to remember and recognize that it all starts with Jesus. Jesus. He is grace personified. So what must we do to receive the blessings and promises? Simply believe. Simply believe that in Jesus and his finished work on the cross for you on your behalf, his death, watch, was your death. His resurrection was your resurrection. And now his life is your life. That's why I love baptism Sunday. That's why we've committed in 2020 to do more baptisms twice a month instead of once a month. Why? Because we want people who have come into grace to experience the goodness of God to start walking out their new identity in Christ. That's what the early church did. They said, what's stopping you from getting baptized? I think we should have baptisms every Sunday. Come on, somebody. But we've got to recognize that it's a picture of our old life and our new life. Ephesians 1:3, through Christ, God has blessed us with every spiritual blessing that heaven has to offer. Why is this so important? Because it's opposite of every other religion. Every other religion. Every other religion will teach you that God's blessings come through religion or rules or rituals or regulations, but that's not the case. We believe here at First Assembly Church that Jesus is the source and the supply of every blessing that you will ever need in your life. Romans 9:16, the Apostle Paul, he writes it this way. God's blessings are not given because somebody decides to have them or works hard to get them, but they are given because God takes pity on those he wants to. That word pity is another word translated for the word grace. God does everything in your life because of grace. He wants to do it because, not because you deserve it, but because he's a good father who wants to give it. What is grace? Come on up here, Robert Poe. Can you write this for me? Because your handwriting is so much better. What is grace? What is grace? Give Robert Poe a good God bless you today. Come on, give Robert Poe. Love you, man. What is grace? I'm going to give you an acronym for the word grace right there. So just write G-A-R-C-E up and down right here. And we got the board cleaned. If you were here Wednesday night, we got the board cleaned. Come on. Grace. What is grace? What is grace? Here it is right here. God's. G is God. God's, and put an apostrophe S right there. God's riches. God's riches at Christ's expense. God's riches at Christ's expense. This is grace. God's riches at Christ's expense. Romans 5:10, look what this says right here. Look at the screen. Since we were brought back to God by the death of his son, oh, Christ's expense, how much did it cost? It cost him everything. It cost him everything. Since we were brought back to God by the death of his son, what blessings, oh, I love this right here, must he have for us now that we are his friends? I don't know about you, but I want to be a friend of God in 2020. When you come into right relationship with God by repenting of your sins and believing in Jesus Christ, you become a friend of God. Look at this. When you become his friend, it says this, he has blessings for his friends. And he is living within you. Woo, doggy. I don't know about you. What if you began to believe that in 2020? What if you began to believe that because you've got him living on the inside of you, that you've got his blessings now living on the inside of you too? That's powerful right there. Give Robert a good God bless you today. Give him a good God bless you. Christ's riches at God's expense. Number two, you can write this down. How do we operate? How do we live? How do we begin to in 2020 and beyond in this next decade? How do we begin to walk in the blessings of God? Number two, you can write this down anywhere. We reveal God's blessings, watch, by applying God, the word of God. We receive the blessings through Christ, but then number two, we reveal God's blessings by applying the word of God. Psalms chapter 112, verses 1 through 9. Quickly, go there in your Bible. Go there in your smartphone. This has been a passage of scripture that my wife and I have been meditating on for 2020. I want to open up some things to you right here quickly today. We're not going to spend long on this. But when you are in Christ, you receive God's blessings through Jesus Christ. The next thing that we want for you to grow in is learning to apply the Word of God. A mentor of mine would tell me, Jeremy, if you would work the word will work. If you work the word will work. Read the word. Do what it says. It's that simple. Read the word. Do what it says. The word, watch. The word of God, watch, reveals the will of God. The word of God reveals the will of God. And if you believe his word and apply it to your life, he will fulfill his promises to you. Psalms chapter 112, verses 1 through 9. I'm going to read this quickly to you, and I'm going to show you some things. I'm going to show you some qualities of a blessed person in 2020. A blessed person that applies the word of God. You ready? Here we go. Somebody say yes. Blessed is the man or woman who fears the Lord, who delights greatly in his commandments. I love this right here. His descendants will be mighty on the earth. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches will be in his house, and his righteousness endures forever. Unto the upright there arises light in the darkness. He is gracious and full of compassion and righteous. A good man deals graciously and lends. He will guide his affairs with discretion. Surely he will never be shaken. The righteous will be in everlasting remembrance. He will not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. His heart is established, and he will not be afraid until he sees his desire upon his enemies. He has dispersed abroad. He's given to the poor. His righteousness endures forever. His horn will be exalted with honor. There's a powerful passage of scripture. I'm going to give you five things quickly. These are five qualities of a blessed person that applies the word of God to their life, that releases God's blessing, right? You can write them down anywhere. In light of the finished work of the cross, number one, first, look what it says in verse one. Blessed is the man who fears the Lord. This doesn't mean that you have to be afraid of the Lord. It says, blessed is the one that reveres and worships the Lord. In the Amplified Version, it says this, to revere. To revere something is to love unquestioningly or love to the place of excess, to regard with feelings of respect or to consider it holy. Watch. A person that reveals God's blessings in 2020 truly loves God without question, even to the point of excess. As new covenant believers, watch, we love out of a revelation of how much we've been loved in Christ Jesus. My worship, my praise, my love for God is a reflection of how much I believe that I have received the love of God in my life. His initial love downward drives, watch, my love upward. His love for you, sending his son Jesus Christ to die on a cross for you and to bless you, hit love that drives love downward, drives my love upward. I love because 1 John says he loved me first. Listen, a person that walks in the blessings of God, watch, has such a respect for God that they will refuse to conduct themselves in a way that would ever break God's heart in any way. When you stay in connection with God's word and you say, God, I love you, God, and I don't want to do anything that would break your heart. And that love downward and that love upward, when that thing connects, it makes you not want to break the heart of God. As you move into this next decade, I want you to live with a worshipful awareness of how close you are to God right now. Number two, it says this, verse one, that blessed man or woman delights greatly in his commandments. The word delight means this, a feeling of extreme pleasure or satisfaction. That means that a blessed man or woman loves the word of God. They can't get enough of it. It's like a precious treasure to them. It's like they never consider it a chore, but a privilege to spend time with the written word of God. Watch, because the written word reveals the living word. The written word of God reveals the living word of God. And nothing thrills a blessed man or woman more than spending quality time in the word of God. Watch. And they spend time in the local church where the word of God is taught. And as they stay planted, the Holy Spirit, watch, imparts revelation knowledge that allows them to flourish. That's why the Bible says it's important that we don't forsake the gathering of ourselves together. Why? Because when the word of God is declared, watch, we receive it. God gives us revelation through his Holy Spirit. Then we get to go out and display it. That's why our mission here at First Assembly Church is simple, to declare and display the gospel to everyone, every day, everywhere. And the word of God is central to that. Number three, quickly, Pastor Deshaun, come. Third, The blessed man or woman deals graciously and lends. Watch, that person that reveals God's blessing is very generous. In other words, they're a giver. Can't get around it. The Bible says you're blessed when you give. 4, verses 6 through 8. It says you'll never be shaken, not afraid of evil things. Their heart's going to be steadfast. They trust the Lord. Their heart is established. They won't be afraid. Watch, the person that reveals God's blessings in 2020 is the kind of person who's not easily moved by bad news. That's why we don't preach bad news here at First Assembly Church. We preach good news. We preach good news because when your heart's established in good news, you'll be able to stand firm against bad news. There's enough bad news that's out there, but child of God, last time I checked, last chapter of the book says we win. We win. God gives you two choices. You win or you win. Come on, somebody. You either win in this life or you win in the next one. I don't know about you, but I can't lose. All I do is win. All I do is win. All I... Anyway. All I do is win. That's what God promised me in 2020. Look at this right here. Number 5. Verse 9. A blessed man or woman, look, it disperses abroad and gives to the poor. I love this right here. Again, it declares that a giving heart is what God looks for. Another translation says it this way. A person that produces God's blessings distributes them freely, and their generosity goes on and on and on. This person actually, watch, lives to give. I want that to be, this is one of our values at First Assembly Church. We believe in irrational generosity. We've learned the meaning of it's more blessed to give than it is to receive. A blessed person in 2020 is a giver. It states 4 different times in this passage of Scripture that God blesses the giver. He shows favor to the giver. He opens doors for the person that lends, that disperses abroad, that gives to the poor. You just can't ignore this principle in this passage that a blessed person in 2020 is someone that gives. And many people mistakenly think that when I have more, then Pastor, I'll start giving. It doesn't work that way. Giving by faith is what produces, watch, more in your life. Proverbs 11:24, you can see it on the screen behind you. One person gives freely, yet gains even more, but another person, watch, withholds, but unduly comes to poverty. We give freely, watch, and more comes back. We withhold, we're stingy, we're hoarders, and what happens? We come to poverty. The Bible says a blessed person in 2020, a blessed person in the next decade is one that learns the principle that I live to give. I live to give. Number 3, write this down. How do we operate in God's blessings? We receive God's blessings through Christ. We reveal God's blessings by applying the Word of God. Watch. Number 3, we respond to God's blessings by faith. Now watch. I'm going to teach you here for a second. God blesses, watch. God blesses people who expect Him to bless them. Hebrews 11:1. Take a look at the screen. Look at your Bible. Hebrews 11:1. Only faith can guarantee the blessings that we hope for. Only faith can guarantee the blessings that we hope. Watch. Only faith in Jesus Christ, only faith in God can activate the blessings we hope for. And God loves it when we trust Him, when we expect Him to take care of us. It's actually a compliment. I know many people that have come to me and say, Pastor, I don't know how to handle this problem. I don't have enough wisdom. My answer is simply begin to pray. God, I trust you that you have the wisdom that I need. People come and say, Pastor, I'm in so deep. I'm in so deep. And I feel like I'm going under. Begin to pray this way. God, I declare, even though things are getting deep around me, you are the rock on which I stand. Begin to, you know, people that say, listen, Pastor, my body is still racked with pain. Begin to pray this way. God, I declare that you took upon yourself every sickness and every disease so that I would not have to. That you took it upon your back so that I wouldn't have to take it on mine. I've got debts, Pastor. Begin to pray that, God, I believe that you've already provided for me everything I need in Christ Jesus today. Listen, by faith, we declare that, God, you have blessed us in the past. And if you've blessed us in the past, I'm certain that you're going to do it again today. I don't know what you're doing, and I don't know what the solution may be right now, God. I don't know where it's going to come from, but I believe your word that says, your ways are higher than my ways. Your thoughts are higher than my thoughts. So God, no matter which way it comes, God, I know that you've got a way to get it to me. That even when I don't have the thoughts left to think, you've thought it from every which way, that God still has a thought for how to get it to you. We begin to declare that God, by faith, you are a God of blessing. You've blessed me in Christ, and I'm expecting a blessing. Watch. When you look at the rearview mirror of your life, watch. The rearview mirror of your life is one of the greatest predictors of what God's going to do for you in your future. Because what God did in the past, watch, he's the same yesterday, he's the same today, he'll be the same tomorrow. That's who he is, Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. I'm here to declare to you today, he's the same God that created the heavens and the earth. He's the same God that blessed Abraham and walked with Enoch. The same God, he's the same God that called Moses and delivered Israel from his enemies. The same God that directed Joshua to conquest, he's the same God that favored Esther in front of kings. He's the same God that shut the mouth of lions. He's the same God that provided food for Elijah from some dirty birds. He's the same God that healed Naaman from a disease and provided food in the middle of a wilderness. He's the same God that filled the temple with his presence. He's the same God that resurrected Lazarus from the dead and saved Peter from drowning off the side of a boat. He's the same God that came down as a man in Jesus Christ. He is the same God that overcame sin and defeated death and changed the world. And here's the word for you today. Here's the good news. Child of God, that he's still walking. He's still calling. He's still delivering. He's still directing. He's still favoring. He's still healing. He's still providing. He's still filling. He's still resurrecting. He's still saving. He's still defeating death, hell, and the grave. He's still overcoming. He's still crushing Satan underneath his feet. He is still changing the world. Why? Because what he did yesterday is what he does today. And what he does today, he's got to do tomorrow. He can't help but be who he is. And that's a good place for you to clap your hands and shout right now, because he's the same God. He's the same God. Watch, the world, watch. The world around us focuses on the things it doesn't have. As a new covenant believer in 2020, we don't think and focus the way the rest of the world thinks it focuses. We don't speak the dead language of lack and longing. We speak the language of filling and blessing. Listen, child of God, you have a faith that moves mountains on the inside of you. Child of God, you have a joy that's unspeakable and full of glory. Child of God, you've got a faith that passes your understanding. Child of God, you have an anointing that destroys the yoke of bondage. Child of God, you've got new mercies that are found every single morning. Child of God, you have Jesus. And if you've got Jesus, you've got all that heaven has to offer you. You may think, as I hear people that say this, well, Pastor, I'm just waiting on God to bless me. No, the truth is this. You're not waiting on your blessing. Watch, your blessing is waiting on you. Your blessing is waiting on you. Child of God, I hope you get up today with some holy faith. Get up today. Grab a hold of that blessing that's in the spirit realm. Declare that it's been accomplished until it manifests in the natural. Here's a word for somebody today. You may not have received what you've been praying for when you expected it, but here's a word. I believe this is a word for somebody today. You may not have received it when you asked for it, but when it manifests, it will be better than you ever thought it could be. I believe that. 2 Corinthians, take a look at the screen. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8. God can pour on the blessings in astonishing ways so that you're ready for anything and everything. I declare that over you. I declare in 2020 that God is going to pour on blessings in astonishing ways so that you're ready for anything and everything. Any weapon that the enemy may try to form against you, watch, none of them's going to prosper in 2020. None of them's going to prosper in 2020. Why? Because you'll be prepared for anything and everything. What are you expecting God to do? Here's a question for you today as we get ready to close. What are you expecting God to do in your life, in this next year, in this next decade? What are you expecting God to do? I already know what he's going to do, and I'm not a prophet. This is according to your Bible. You have it in your word. Matthew 9:29. Look what it says. According to your faith, it will be done unto you. In 2020, God will do exactly what you expect him to do. No more, no less. You get to decide how much he will bless your life. According to your faith in what he's already done for you. Go back to number one, in Christ Jesus. Every time God did a miracle, every time he moved heaven and earth, it was because somebody believed. You want to walk in God's blessings in your life in 2020 and the next decade? Begin expecting it. Begin believing it, that it's already been accomplished for you in Christ Jesus. Let me teach you for a second here. I hear people say, but Pastor, I can't see my blessings. I can't see my blessings. Watch this. Faith in what Jesus has accomplished for you. Faith determines, watch, your favor. Watch, faith determines your favor. Your focus, your sight, determines your feelings. I need to teach some of you this year. Faith is what determines your favor. But your focus, your eyes, what your eyes are looking at, that is what determines your feelings. But the last time I read my Bible, I don't walk by my feelings. We walk by faith and not by sight. The enemy may try to put your sight on your happiness, but he can't take your joy in Christ Jesus. The enemy may try to take your money, get your focus on your money, but you have riches found in Christ Jesus. The enemy might try to take your clothes, your suit, your fake Gucci outfit that you got on right now. But he can't take your armor that's found in Christ Jesus. The enemy may try to take your night, but he can't have your morning. The enemy may have tried to take your past, but he can't have your future. Why? We live by faith and not by sight. The enemy will try to get you to focus and shrink your focus only into what you can see. However, our faith, watch. This is powerful. You don't want to miss this. Your faith grows not by what you see, but watch. Well, the Word of God declares this. Not by what you see, but by what you hear. Romans chapter 10, verse 17. Look at this. Consequently, what? Faith comes by what? Hearing the message. And the message is heard through the words of who? Christ. Oh, here we go. Here is a physical and spiritual truth. That when your eyesight begins to diminish, watch, the very first sense of your five senses that begins to pick up is your hearing. Now, I don't want to bug anybody today, but can you just shout this with me? Can you just shout this? If I can hear it, I can have it. If I can hear it, then I can have it. Oh, here we go. Can you hear what Christ says about you right now? I'm talking about what Jesus says about you. I want to show you quickly in 2020, if you can hear it, you can have it. If you can hear the message of Christ, what is the message of Christ? Not that everybody drives a Lamborghini. Come on, somebody. What is the message of Christ? Number one, he says that you are free from the law of sin and death. Romans chapter 8, verse 2. If you can hear that you are free. Listen, free people set free people free. I want you in 2020 to begin to walk like a free person. Talk like a free person. You may not see your freedom just yet, but listen, that doesn't mean that your freedom hasn't been given in Christ Jesus. You have been set free from the law of sin and death. Romans 8, 2. Can you hear him say that over your life? Listen, what does he say over you? He says that you have the mind of Christ. 1 Corinthians 2, 16. You have the mind of Christ. I know that there are confusing things that we have to deal with. But in the middle of the confusion, can you hear the words of Jesus speak peace over you? That you have the mind of Christ. What else does he say? He says that you have peace beyond your understanding. Philippians 4:19. What else does he say? Philippians 4:7. He says that you have no lack for anything because God supplies all of your needs. What else does he say? He says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, that you can do all things through Christ who gives you strength. He says that you're an overcomer and a conqueror, Romans 8, 37. He says that you're healed by his stripes, Isaiah 53, 5. He says that you're a joint heir with Christ Jesus in Romans chapter 8, verse 17. Listen, child of God, in 2020, if you can hear it, you can have it. I want you to begin to allow God to not just focus your eyes, but also open your ears. That's why Jesus said that those that have ears to hear, let them hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Why? Because if you can hear it, you can have it. Come on, somebody. If I can hear it, I can have it. Not by my faith, but by faith in what Jesus has accomplished for me. Last thing, number four, we're going to pray. I have some things to declare over you. Number four, you can write this down. We receive God's blessings through Christ. We reveal God's blessings through applying the Word of God. We respond to God's blessings by faith. And then number four, we replicate God's blessings with other people. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8. Here's the scripture verse. God is able to provide you with every blessing in abundance so that by always having enough of everything, you may, watch, share abundantly in every good work. God doesn't want you just to be blessed so that your life is blessed. He wants to use your life in 2020 and in this next decade in a great way. He wants to bless you so that you can be a blessing to other people. At First Assembly Church, listen, we don't teach Jesus' generous practices. Watch. We practice Jesus' generous teachings. We practice it. We put it into practice. When something, watch, leaves your hand towards God, something leaves God's hand towards you. That's why in Acts 20 it says this. Remember that the Lord Jesus said it's more blessed to give than it is to receive. Here's our life application today. Are you getting this? Somebody say yes.
Yes.
The greatest blessings you could ever give anybody, watch. We're going to get to our life application in a second, but the greatest blessing you could ever give anybody is to introduce them to Jesus Christ. It all starts right there. Introducing them to Jesus Christ. So we're going to pray for that, number one. In just a moment, we're going to pray for you today. If you may be here and you say, Pastor, I have not yet made that decision, or maybe I made it a long time ago, and today I want to restart my life in Christ, then we're going to pray for that for you. But then number two, I'm going to declare some things prophetically that the Lord's given me over this house. If you can hear it, you can have it. I want you to begin to elevate your faith, to begin to believe and receive all that Christ has for you. Stand with me if you would, please, today. We're going to pray together and get you walking out the door. I'm going to ask pastors and prayer partners and elders to come position themselves around the front. We'll have a time to pray. If you need prayer for anything specifically today, we believe at First Assembly Church in the power of prayer and agreement. The Bible says in James that if there be any sick among you, to call the elders of the church, anoint them with oil. Prayer offered in faith will make the sick person well. If you need healing in your body today, if you need prayer for a miracle, we want to pray with you. You pray for children, situation. Listen, whatever it is, the altar and prayer service will start at the conclusion of our time together today. Before I let you go out this door today, would you just slip your hands towards heaven today? Put your eyes on Jesus just for a moment. Almighty God, we come to you in the name of Jesus today with hands lifted up, with in a position to receive from you what you've already freely given to us in Christ. Father, we believe today that you have unlocked heaven for us in Christ. Today, we do not want to limit in any way your blessings in our lives. So today, with hands lifted, we just simply say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now, with hands lifted, nobody looking around, if you'd say, Pastor, I hear what you're saying, but I've never encountered grace before. I've never encountered God's riches at Christ's expense. I've never asked Jesus. I've never repented of my sin, and I've never asked him to forgive me. I've never asked him to live in my life and be the Lord of my life. Or maybe you did a long time ago, and you want to rededicate your life to the Lord today and start 2020 off on the right path. With nobody looking around today, nobody's looking at you. But today I'm going to ask you to take a bold step today. I don't normally do this, but today I'm going to ask you to take a bold step today. Again, it's God's love downward to us that drives our upward love to him. He took the first step. And so today, if you're here and you'd say, Pastor, nobody's looking around, but you'd say, Pastor, that's me. I want to ask Jesus to be the Lord of my life. I want to receive Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. And here's what I'm going to ask you to do. When I say three, I'm going to ask you to simply slip out of your seat. I want you to come forward, and I want you to be able to tell some prayer partner, elder, or pastor that I want to receive Jesus, and they're going to pray with you right there. This is not meant to embarrass anybody. Jesus, He left heaven and earth. He left heaven to come to earth so that way you could leave earth to go to heaven. One, you've heard this message. Two, the Holy Spirit is moving on the inside of you. You know this is right. You know you need to take a step. Three, if that's you, slip out of your seat right now and come on forward. We want to pray with you. We want to pray. Nobody's looking around. Nobody's looking around. People will move for you if you need them to move. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Nobody's looking around. I see people moving. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now, everybody with hands lifted, I'm going to declare these blessings over you. I want you to receive them by faith. If you receive them, I just want you to say, thank you, Jesus, as I declare these over you. Almighty God, we thank you right now in the name of Jesus for those that are receiving your life. But now, Lord, I declare things over your people. I declare and decree over your people today that they are blessed. If you believe that, say, thank you, Jesus. I declare that God's divine favor has been spoken over you, and I declare that over the next 7 days, you will experience preferential treatment. I declare that you will have supernatural increase. I declare that restoration will come in your relationships. I declare increased assets and great victories will be yours this week in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the favor of God will show up now and in your future. I declare that handfuls of God's blessings are being dropped on you right now. I declare that you will walk in unprecedented favor and that no obstacle will stop you. I declare that your influence with your job will increase in 2020. I declare that you will be fully resourced to fulfill God's work in your life and what He's assigned for you to do. I declare that you're blessed in the city and you're blessed in the country. I declare that you are a child of God. I declare you're blessed going in and you're blessed coming out. I declare that whatever rises up against you will be defeated. I declare that when it comes at you one way, it must flee in seven different directions. Because I declare you are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. I declare that you will start stepping into your promises, that you will start speaking with faith about your future. I declare that you will start declaring that in every season, you will be fruitful and productive. I declare that your health will thrive. I declare your family will thrive. I declare that your home will thrive. I declare that your finances will thrive. I declare your children and grandchildren will thrive. And I declare that every place your foot goes, God has given it to you in faith. Father, I thank you that this is a year of breakout at First Assembly Church, that your church will break out and break in and break through every obstacle that the enemy has tried to hold them back with. And I declare that in 2020 and beyond, that, Lord, you will allow them to take out and break out of whatever stands in their way of a healthy, happy, healed, holy, honoring life. Because, Jesus, you are their Lord. You are the Lord of breakout in 2020. In Jesus' name. And if you believe it and receive it by faith, would you clap your hands and give God a good praise today? Amen. 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 Give them a good praise today. Come on. You're blessed. You're blessed. Now, child of God, next Sunday, I'm going to be teaching you biblically how to set goals that God will bless. You don't want to miss it, because your next year and 10 years are going to be blessed. Bring somebody with you next week. The altar service starts now. God bless you. We'll see you right back here Wednesday night, 7 o'clock midweek. Child of God, be blessed.